Hi, yogis. It's me again with Wendy and John and Journey. Woohoo! Okay, so we are doing a Vashistasana practice today. Some of you have actually done this practice with me before, so it might seem a little bit familiar. But we're going to start in a comfortable seat. So find easy seat, Sukhasana, crossing the shins. And if this feels like too much on your hips, you can always grab a pillow or even like a couch cushion and elevate your sit bones, and it allows the knees to drop a little bit lower than the hips, and it alleviates any hip pressure. Today, I want you to take your palms face down and take Jnana Mudra. So thumb and first finger together, root down through the sit bones and lift up through the crown of the head. You'll feel your spine get super long, and close the eyes. Breath. Start to notice. As you're sitting here, I want you to just check in with your energy. Where are you at energetically? If you are kind of sucking mud, where you're low energy and need a little boost, place your palms up. Keep your thumb and first finger together. If you're feeling like you need some grounding, palms face down. If you need one of each, flip. Left palm up, right palm down. That's usually where I'm at. So just start to draw the breath in through the nose. Start to follow the breath. Allow it to expand the chest, the lungs, the belly, the space through the ribs. As we practice Vashistasana, we are going to focus on, our intention is that we are the architect of our own life. So, meaning we get to choose. We get to choose not all the circumstances, but I believe that we can manifest and pull in, draw in what we want. There are times where things aren't exactly what we want, but guess what? We get to choose our perspective. We get to choose the way that we meet those challenges, and that can change the whole thing. So we're going to breathe into that space. So take a big inhale through the nose. Draw the breath in, expand and open. Once you get the breath to the top, hold. Make sure the shoulders are away from the ears, rooting down through the sit bones. And open the mouth, exhale, let it go. Good, again, inhale from the bottom of the belly, start to expand and open. Take the breath all the way up into the chest. Feel that expansion in your chest. Feel like you grow and you're lifting the chest up towards the ceiling. And then open the mouth, exhale, let it go. One more just like that, inhale. Open the mouth, exhale. Beautiful. So you get to choose within every asana, every pose today, your architecture, what you want the pose to feel and be like. And then we're gonna take that off of our mat today. Well, after class. All right, guys, blink the eyes open. Sit up nice and tall. Good, smile. And then take the arms forward and clasp the fingertips. Press the palms forward. Inhale, lift the arms up. Draw the shoulder blades down the back, shoulder heads away from the ears. Reach up through the crown of the head and then drop over to the right, but rest the ear on the right bicep. Keep rooting through the left sit bone. Really fan the ribs open. Try not to lower the left armpit, so even revolve open just a little bit. Good, inhale up through center. Reach up and then over to the left. You can let your head hover in between, but if your neck just needs a break, let it rest. Put the ear rest on the bicep. Root down through the right sit bone, reach, open through the chest. Inhale up through center. Beautiful. Release the fingertips. You're going to find downward facing dog at the top of the mat. So crawl yourself to the top of the mat. Spread the fingers wide. And just like we did last week, we're really going to focus on the thumb and first finger because we are doing a lot of side plank variations. Not that side plank flow we did last week, but side plank variations. We really want to alleviate any pressure, pain in the wrist. So really focus on the thumb and the first finger, those knuckles rooting down, wrapping the triceps towards the floor, biceps forward. Move around, wiggle, like these first 3 to 5 breaths are your, it's your time to find your dog. If it feels good to start to lower the crown of the head towards the floor, maybe grabbing the outside edge of the mat, kind of wiggling and flossing into the upper back, the shoulder blades. I love Vashistasana. It's one of those poses that really is architectural and you have to have a firm foundation, a sturdy foundation. From your plank or from your down dog, come forward into plank pose. Good. Grip the floor with the fingertips. Press and round through the upper back, but simultaneously broaden through the collarbones. So we're not trying to collapse here. We're still pulling the heart forward, tailbone down. And then take chaturanga slow. Lower halfway down. Drop the pelvis. Lift the heart. Cobra pose. Good. Curl the toes under. Lift the hips up and back. Down dog. Awesome. Plank pose. Again. Chaturanga halfway. One more time. Pelvis down. Heart lifts. Well, not one more time. We'll do this again. Curl the toes, lift the hips up and back. Uno mas, this time it's a push-up. Come forward, plank pose. Chaturanga lower halfway. Press up, plank. Beautiful, hips up and back, down dog. Do you guys need two more? Mm-hmm. I feel like, yeah, okay, plank pose. I gotta get the signature in there. Chaturanga. Plank pose, down dog. Okay, now for real, one more time. Plank. Chaturanga. Grip with the fingertips. Press yourself up. Plank. Downward facing dog. Walk the hands back to the feet. Good. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Knees can be bent here, but I want you to lift the sit bones up and spread them apart, even if the knees are bent. Grab opposite elbows if you want. Find ragdoll. Just hang. You can sway. Breathe into the hamstrings, lifting those sit bones up. Good, then release the fingertips. Sweep the arms back behind the low back, and then press the knuckles up, drop the hands over. The palms together. This is pretty easy. Squeeze those guys. Oh, we lost our music. Good. One more breath. Pull the belly in and up. Release the hands down. Bend through the knees. Drop the tailbone and roll up vertebrae by vertebrae. Bring the shoulders back to the ears. Take them back. And then shimmy the shoulder blades down the back. Walk to the top of the mat. So once you get to the top of the mat, big toes touch, hands to the heart, and eyes close. All right, setting an intention, a purpose for this movement on our mat today. We are our own architects. So even if my plans or the people behind me, maybe their plans are a little bit different for this practice, that's okay. This is your practice, you're the architect, and you get to choose how it goes and your perspective. So, big inhale through the nose.
Open the mouth, exhale, seal it in. Good, release the arms by your sides. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lift the chin. Exhale, step or jump back, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Just one breath, big inhale. Exhale. Grip the floor with the thumb and first finger, wrap the triceps. Lift the heels, bend the knees. Grip, lift the hips, step, let it fly. Lengthen through the spine, back of the neck. Exhale, fold. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, hands to your sides, Namaste. Again, inhale. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift the chin. Exhale, step or float it back, chaturanga. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha. Exhale, Adho Mukha. Big breath in. Breath out. Good, lift the heels. Bend the knees. Step, loader fly. Lengthen and fold. Inhale, arms reach. Exhale, arms release. Samasthiti. Last one. Inhale, last three, Namaskar A. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha. Exhale, hips up and back, downward facing dog. Inhale, sweep the right leg high. Lift the left heel. Lower the heel, open the hip, and the knee stretch. Okay, now today, I want you to pull your outer left hip back, like you're trying to unwrinkle your yoga pants. So really pull it back, lift the knee. Good, extend the leg. Pull the knee to the nose, give it a kiss. Lift the hips, come really high on the tippy toes. Look forward, step the foot in between the hands. Spin the back heel down, we want heel to arch here. Bring the right hand to the inside of the right leg. Okay, from here, use your tricep. Press that knee open so it's directly over the second toe. Left arm lifts. Take the tailbone, bring it towards the left heel. Really revolve open, maybe look up. If it bothers your neck at all, just look down at your big toe. Breathe here, find length in your side body. Really swing the right hip in. It's almost like you're pressing your pelvis forward. Good, lower the left hand to the inside of the foot. Lift the heel high, bring the right arm up. Dragonfly twist. Breathe into your dragonfly twist. Okay, first Vashistasana, before you move into it, grip the left fingers into the mat, pull the left shoulder blade down the back, shoulder head away from the ear. Roll to the outer edge of the left foot and stack the right foot on top. You can always kickstand the right leg in front, but from here you're strong, the shoulders down the back, gripping the floor with the fingertips. Lift the right leg up, off of the left, bend the knee, place the toes back behind, and roll open, Vashistasana, or sorry, wild leg. Open through the front body, throw. Good, look up, take the right arm up. Right hand down, keep the right leg lifted. You're in a three-point plank. Chaturanga. Drop the top of the foot, lift
knit the ribs in and together. Reach to the fingertips so you're not just kind of like hanging out the arms. Reach. So how's your foundation in the architect, the plans of this warrior one? Exhale, hands to the mat. Lift the back heel, press the ground away, round. Step the foot back. Try not to slide. Chaturanga. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Beautiful. Inhale, left leg lifts. Lift the right heel. Shimmy back. Hip flexor into the socket. And then drop the heel, open the hip, bend the knee, stretch. Right armpit lifts. Outer right hip pulls back. So you're not going to be in this pose as deep as you were, because you're going to try to get all the wrinkles out of that right side. Press the hands, lift the knee up, pull the outer right hip back. Good. Square the hip off, send the leg back. Pull the knee to the nose, shoulders over the wrist. Right heel lifts, give the knee a kiss. Look forward, step. Spin the right heel down, heel to arch. Take a moment, get your foundation set. Left hand pulls to the inside of the left foot. Right arm lifts. All right. I know you're looking at my backside, but I hope you can kind of see as I cue my body doing what I'm asking it to. So I'm pushing that knee open with my tricep, my shoulder. From there, I'm taking my tailbone and pushing it toward my right heel. Okay, then I'm swinging my pelvis forward slightly. I'm still long through my side body. This arm, the top arm, doesn't go back behind the shoulder. In fact, it should be in front. And then revolve to meet it. Good, right hand to the mat. Lift the right heel high. Lift the left arm up, dragonfly twist. We're preparing. Get your right shoulder set into the socket. Grip the floor with the fingertips. Roll to the outer edge of the right foot. Stack the left foot. Press through the hand. Reach up. Good. Vashistasana. Side plank, strong pose. Lift the left leg, bend the knee, drop the toes back behind, roll open wildly. Okay, it's like a little dance that we're moving into. Lift the left arm up, lower the hand to the mat, but the left leg stays lifted. Chaturanga, drop the foot, lift the heart. Back to chaturanga, leg is hovering. Press up, plank. Use that leg, lift the hips up and back. Three leg dog. Pull the knee to the nose, round. Step the foot between the hand. Back heel spins down, warrior one. So really pushing, rooting through the outside of the right foot, the outer edge. Really strong through your right leg. Left sit bone down and forward, square the hips off. Try to lift up your right arch. That's how much you're pressing into the outer edge a little bit. Reach the fingers. Exhale, hands to the mat. Step back, plank pose. Chaturanga. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Five breaths. Breathe in your down dog. If you need a little break, drop down to child's pose. But breathe wherever you are, breathe. Sometimes, hi Capri. Sometimes to get this like really good foundation, we need a rest. It's better to rest and give your body a little break so your poses don't get sloppy and you don't injure yourself. So breathe here, one more breath. Remember that thumb and first finger, lift the heels, bend the knees, look forward, step butterfly. Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, pull the belly in and out, full Uttanasana. Bend the knees, sink the hips, Utkatasana. Pull the weight back into the heels so you can lift the toes up. Maybe they even kind of flutter. Drop the tailbone down, scoop the low belly. You can sit down just a little bit more, I'm not going to be your mom. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift and lengthen, shoulders away from the ears. Exhale, step or float back, chaturanga.
You are your own architect. Lift the heart. Exhale, lift the hips. Spin the left heel in, step the right foot forward. So without swinging the leg, use your core, warrior one. Look up. Exhale, hands to the mat. Lift the back heel, press it around and step back. With intention, chaturanga. Upward facing dog. Play around with your fingers, gripping them into the mat, downward facing dog. Right heel spins in, left foot steps. Starting to get warm. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, hands to the mat. Release, step that foot back without dragging it. Chaturanga. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Take three breaths. Inhale. And exhale. Good. From here, inhale, right leg lifts. Lift the left heel, pull the knee to the nose, round. Step the foot between the hands. Warrior one, reach. Good, and then open it up, heel to arch alignment, warrior two. I'm gonna mess with your warrior two just a little bit today. So instead of really trying to pull the hips open, I want you to pivot your left hip bone forward just a little bit. And notice as you pull the left hip forward a little bit, you can pull that right femur into the socket and maybe even deepen the pose a little bit. Arms reach. Soft, light toes. Shoulders away from the ears. Maybe close the eyes. You are your architect. A pose like warrior two is strong. And it's very intentional. And the lines are very exact. And this is a hard pose. Especially when we're holding it. We don't know when the end is coming. So can you shift your perspective? Manifest what you want. What do you want out of this pose? Flip your right palm. Reverse. Stretch back. Stretch to your right side. Reach. And then super lightly, or you hover the right forearm on the thigh. Left arm lifts. Remember that hip is pulling forward slightly. Okay, you should be able to lift that hand off of your thigh and start to bring your forearm to your knee and then lower it down the shin. Press into the shin, press the shin back into the forearm. You're revolving the torso up, maybe look up. You're gonna feel burning, it's okay. Good, stay here or lift the hand, place it on the outside of the foot. Spin your left pinky in and reach. You can always use a block. You can look up under your left armpit or down at the right big toe. Good, strong through the legs. Inhale, warrior two. Straighten through the right leg, turn the toes in. Good, hands to the waist, inhale, lift the heart. Exhale, fold forward. Good, inhale, lift and lengthen. Walk the hands forward, lift the heels, weight into the fingertips. Exhale, heels to the mat. Walk the hands back, this is Prasarita Padottanasana A. A perfect setup for a tripod headstand, Shirsasana B. So if you walk those hands back, and the head comes to the mat, even if you need to bend your knees. Make sure your foundation is set, shoulders away from the ears, squeezing the elbows together, and you'll gently start to come up. Beautiful, you guys. Everybody's final product is gonna be different. Start to spread the legs wide, flex through the feet, pivot at the hip and lower the feet to the mat. Slow and steady. Good, inhale, lift the heart. Let the blood rush back to your head. Hands to the waist, rise up. Turn the right toes forward, warrior two. Practice that little pivot with the hip. Cartwheel the arms down. Step the right foot underneath the belly button. Okay, foundation here. Grip through the fingertips, wrap the triceps, shoulder blades Once the legs go up into the air, stay mindful of the legs. Step or foot it back, chaturanga. Through the vinyasa. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. I'm not sure if I want my back facing you. Inhale, left leg lifts. Lift the right heel, hips stay high, but pull the knee to the nose. Step the foot. Back heel spins down, warrior one. Open it up, heel to arch, warrior two. Okay, right hip pivots in slightly. Plug the left finger into the socket and then drop the left sit bone down and forward, maybe getting that thigh 90 degrees. Really root through the outer edge of the foot, strong through the arms. I like to close my eyes. Maybe take the tailbone to the back right heel. The chin is over the left shoulder. Gaze is over the left middle finger. Good. So breathe here. This is temporary. Good. Flip the left palm. Guys or troopers, inhale, reverse. Better not have come out of that at home. I know it's way easier to do that when you're at home. Okay, left forearm. Maybe just hovers or lightly place it on the thigh. Right arm lifts. That hip bone is slightly forward. Take the forearm, bring it to the kneecap. Press, stay here, or start to lower it down. You're long through both sides. And press the forearm into the shin, shin into the forearm. It's gonna deepen the pose. Left shoulder down the back. Good, stay here or gently place the hand behind the foot. Spin the right pinky finger forward, reach over the ear. If that's not feeling so good, take the arm forward. Pull the shoulder into the socket, pinky down, and then rotate it. Okay, super strong. Inhale, warrior two. Straighten the left leg, turn the toes forward. Okay, this time, clasp the hands behind the low back. Drop the knuckles down, lift the heart. Exhale, fold. Breathe into the shoulders. Maybe that little flossing back and forth like the beginning of class. Then keep the hands clasped. Start to lift up with a flat back. Good, release the arms, toes forward, warrior two. Right arm over the ear, cartwheel the hands down. Step the left foot back, right foot lifts. You can stay here, standing L. Standing split, or take a couple hops. Get off the legs, couple hops with the hands down. I usually say no more than three, just because we start to get a little tired and we lose the integrity of our foundation. So after your three, or if you're super adventurous today, maybe five, take a vinyasa. From your down dog, our second Vashistasana, plank pose. I know this isn't going to seem very interesting, but take your left hand, place it under your heart, grip the floor, pull the shoulder blade down the back, roll open, Vashistasana. Okay, then for this one, imagine you want to fan your right ribs up towards the ceiling, so we're making an arc. Pinky forward, reach over the ear. Don't just reach over the ear, reach towards the floor. Yeah, see how that gives you even more space. So our side body should look like a rainbow. Good. Lift those hips. I think before I said there's like a campfire underneath and you're trying to lift your ribs away. Good. Take the right arm up. Take the hand down, plank pose. Skip the chaturanga. Take the up dog. Release through the shoulders and the neck. Make sure there's space. Down dog. Plank pose. Right hand under the heart. Get your architecture the way that it should be. Shoulder blade down the back, grip the floor, roll it open.
Then from here, spin the left pinky forward, reach over the ear. But remember, we're not just reaching forward, we're reaching down, and it's gonna start to lift the hips. Maybe your right sole of your foot is completely on the mat. Pull the ribs up, open through your left ribs. You're really pressing through your right hand. If you want, you can look up, challenge your balance, fall gracefully, then lift the left arm. Drop the hand to the mat, plank. Your choice, chaturanga or take it out and find up dog. Downward facing dog. Take three breaths here. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Last breath. Lift the heels, bend the knees, grip the floor, look forward, float to the top of the mat. Lengthen through the spine. Exhale, fold. Inhale, arms reach up. Drag the thumbs to the heart. Anjali Mudra. Okay, we're moving into a tree pose. So we're either going to do tree, you can always keep your toes down on the mat, come to the calf, avoid the knee at all costs. You can bring the foot up into the inner thigh. Some of you, half lotus. Okay, and if you're in half lotus, you can take the arm around, try to bind with the foot, left hand to the heart. If you're in tree pose, you're gonna start to grow your branches. Maybe play with the gaze. And if you wanna take Ardha Padma Paschimottanasana, that's not it, you can lower forward, keeping that bind. Okay, breathe here. I want you to create a little muscle memory of what's going on in the standing pose. Just one more breath, really rooted through that left foot, pulling up through the crown of the heads and the fingers. Good, pull the hands to the heart. Release your tree limb, lower the foot. Okay, second side, so the weight comes onto the right foot, spread through the toes. Taking either tree pose or half lotus. And it doesn't matter which, but whatever you're doing standing right now, we're gonna take and we're gonna do it in just a minute. Not standing. So root through the heel, lift through the crown of the head, my trees, start to grow your branches. My lotuses, grab the foot, maybe start to lower down into a forward fold, keeping your lotus. Breathing here. Good, just one more breath. Awesome, release the hands. Release the foot, lower down. Okay, I gotta walk to the top of my mat. We're gonna take a vinyasa back. Inhale, arms reach. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Step or float it back, chaturanga. Oh, you guys, that was insane. That was so beautiful. Up dog, I'm so glad you got on camera. Downward facing dog. All right, friends, come forward, plank pose. Left hand, place it underneath the heart. Roll open into your side plank. Grip the floor with the fingertips. Whatever tree variation you took, you're gonna find it here in your side plank. So if you took half lotus, take your hand back and try to grab your toes. What? Why can I grab my toes standing and not now? It's so weird to me. Okay, my tree poses, maybe start to lift the hips up. So press the inner thigh to the foot to the inner thigh, maybe start to roll your gaze up. Best part of this pose, plank pose. If you can keep your bind with your leg, keep the bind. Chaturanga. Lower the pelvis and the inner thigh down. Lift the heart up. Should feel good. If it doesn't, don't do it. Curl the toes under, lift the hips up and back, release.
poses. You're gonna reach, press the inner thigh into the leg, leg into the earth foot, foot into the inner thigh. So you're gonna lift up, maybe take the gaze up. If you're in lotus, maybe try to reach around and find. If you're in half lotus, you can even take the gaze up. Everyone, take the gaze up and laugh when you fall. Good, release the arm. Plank pose, maybe keeping the leg where it is. Chaturanga. Inner thigh drops, heart lifts. So good. Lift the hips up and back. Release the foot to the mat. Take 3 breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Last breath. Inhale. Well, just in this pose. Exhale. Reach the right leg high. You know all these secrets. Step the foot in between the hands. Spin the back heel down. Transition, warrior one. Transition open, warrior two. Keep that pivot. Flip the palms, straighten the right leg. Transition into reverse. And then we're gonna sweep forward, reach. Find all the length you can. And then find your triangle pose. Okay, same thing goes here for your top arm. If your hand is back behind your shoulder, bring it forward and then rotate to meet it. If it hurts your neck to look up, look down at the big toe. Take the left hand, bring it to the hip. Look down at the right big toe. Bend the knee and crawl the fingertips forward. You're finding half moon pose. Okay, so a strong half moon pose, you can just see the bottom half of my body. Okay, from here, take your left arm and reach it parallel to the floor. Wendy, you love this. Sweep the left leg to the side like a little fire hydrant. See if you can find your big toe or maybe the foot and hold here. Firm the outer right hip in, hearts forward. Shoulder away from the ears. Good, release the foot. Lower the left foot to meet the right. Lower the left hand to meet the right. Good job, you guys. Inhale, lift the chin. Feet are together, hands plant, lift the heels, separate the knees and find crow pose. Grip the floor, lift the heels, press and round, but at the same time, you're broad through the collarbones. Grip. When you're ready, shoot it back, chaturanga. Yes, up dog. Downward facing dog. Take one breath, inhale. Inhale, left leg high. Lift the heel, bend the knee, pull it in. Step. Warrior one. Open it up, heel to arch, warrior two. Flip the palms, straighten the leg, reach back. Then reach forward, Trikonasana, triangle pose. Hand is forward of the shoulder. Rotate, revolve the rib cage. So you're really squeezing the left ribs forward, right ribs back. Right hand to the hip. Look down at the left big toe. Bend the knee, scooch back. Walk the fingertips forward about a foot in front of the pinky toe and outside just a little bit. And pop up, Ardha Chandrasana. Lift the right hand to the sky. So you're strong through your foundation, your left leg. Drop the hand so it's parallel to the floor, arm reaches. And then sweep that foot into the hand. Good. the chin, lengthen. Plant the hands, lift the heels, bend the knees. Crow pose, Bakasana. Any variation. If Brett were doing this practice, he'd be doing Ekapada Bakasana, one leg to crow. So make it yours. Make the plans yours. Manifest what you want out of this practice. Shoot it back. Chaturanga. Upward facing. Downward facing dog. Okay, big breath. Take a breath in. Fill up the lungs. Exhale. Come forward, plank pose. Starting with the left hand underneath the heart. Wrapping and opening up to the right. Okay, you have options here. You can lower this left knee down for your base, and you're going to pull your right knee into your armpit. Reach and grab your big toe with the first middle finger.
Spin and show you guys from here. Okay, so this, it looks like a dog on a firefighter. Lift the calf so it's parallel to the floor. This may be where you stay, or you start to open the leg, press the pelvis forward super strong through the shoulder. Okay, if you want to take it on the foot, you'll notice my left foot rooted all the way to the ground. I'm pulling my hips up like that one Vashistasana where we're super arched, and then straighten the leg and press the hips forward. When you're ready, release. Plank. Pelvis down, heart lifts. Shake it out. Downward facing dog. Okay, right hand under the heart. Roll open. It's probably good to start with the knee down, just so you can get all of the attention into the foundation. So you'll pull this knee into the chest, like hook. Take your first and middle finger, grab the big toe. Maybe stay here working on lifting the shin parallel, pressing the pelvis forward, or you start to extend, and then press the pelvis forward and open it up. Full Vashi V. Really arcing, sole the foot on the mat, shin parallel, open it up, press. So good. When you're ready, release. Plank. Either chaturanga through or just find up dog. Find a little bit of a release. And down dog. One more little flow. This is our last variation. You'll notice we're standing in these variations and then we're bringing it to the floor of our Vashistasana. Inhale, right leg high. Step the foot in between the hands. Warrior one, same transition. Open it up, heel to arch, warrior two. Inhale, reverse. Straighten through the leg, Trikonasana. Triangle pose, look down at the right big toe. Bend the knee and step the hand forward. Half moon. From your half moon, bend your right left knee, heel to the glute, reach back and see if you can find your foot. Now today, I don't want you to lift your knee. I actually want you to keep it hugging in so it's parallel to the floor. Once you have it parallel to the floor, start to kick the foot back. Lean the back of the head back. Pelvis is reaching forward. So it's like this counterbalance. Avoid this. We're squeezing and it feels like a totally different pose. Good, you guys, release. Arm reaches up. Lower the left hand, lower the left hip. Let's hands down again. It sounds fun to me. Spread the fingers wide. If that's not your plans, don't. Stay in standing splits. Lift the right heel. Make your way to inversion. 3 to 5. Good. Step or float it back. Chaturanga. Down dog. One more side. Inhale. Left leg high.
arch, warrior two. Good, inhale, flip the palm, reverse. Straighten through the leg and reach forward, triangle pose. Look down, bend the knee, hop it up, half moon. Bend the left knee or right knee, kick the glute. I don't know my right and left. Reach back so you can find your ankle or your foot, and then squeeze the inner thighs, kick the foot back. Press the pelvis forward, lean the back of the head back. Open through the shoulder. It's a little bit of a pelvic thrust, just like when we were in that extended side ankle variation. Squeeze the inner thighs. Good, release the leg. Lower the right hand, square the right hip down. Either standing split or float it up. Couple hops. It's really beautiful to me to see everybody's expression is different. You may do this practice again this week or another week, and your expression is going to be totally different. Beautiful, John. Good. Step or float it back, chaturanga. Upward facing, downward facing dog. Shake the head, yes, and you're down dog. Shake the head, no. Shake the head however you want to shake it. Let that neck release. I feel like we hold a lot of tension in these poses. Drop to the knees. Sit back on the heels. Okay, so this is our final. We're basically in half moon, archipasana, grabbing our foot, but we're gonna do it in our side plank. So we'll set up just like we have been. Actually, I'll show you on the right side. Let's start with the knee down. So this is a Kapinjala Asana kind of prep. We're gonna lift the left leg, then kick the heel to the glute, reach back, find the foot or the ankle, squeeze the inner thighs, and then kick the foot into the hand, hand into the foot, and lean the back of the head back. Notice you don't want to lift that knee high. Yes, beautiful. So you can stay here on the knee, or you come to your side plank. Same thing here. Really lift the hips so the sole of my right foot is completely rooted on the mat. Bend the knee, reach back, grab the foot. And there's a pressing of the pelvis forward and then leaning back. Press forward, lean back. Press forward, lean back. Beautiful journey. Good. When you release, come into plank, just up dog. Shoulders back. Make sure the neck is releasing. Down dog. So second side here. Let's all start on our knee. So left hand under the heart. Pivot that shin. Reach the right arm up. Leg lifts. Kick the heel. Reach back. Good. And once you have that, kick the foot back. Press the pelvis forward, heart forward, lean back. Lean. It should feel really open in your right shoulder head, maybe even down through your bicep. Full pose, you'll find your side plank. Take the foot, press the pelvis forward, lean the back of the head back. Press and lean. Press and lean. When you're done playing, plank pose. Take one last chaturanga. So good, you guys. Up dog, downward facing dog. Okay, from here, we're gonna try maybe to hop into our Ardha Matsyendrasana. So you'll lift the heels, bend the knees, and in midair, you're gonna cross your right leg over your left. So it looks more difficult and sounds more difficult than this. You're gonna land on your left shin. Should have flexed my foot. Right leg's on top. Yeah, do we kind of get there? Okay, right arm supports the spine, lifts. Left arm reaches, hook the elbow. So really keep your pelvic bowl fixed. Lift up and revolve. If you wanna take a bind, you can reach that arm under, find a bind here.
My torso is so long, so it actually helps me to lift up, finding the bind and revolve without compromising into my low back. Good, twist forward. Cross the right knee all the way on top of the left. Sit up super tall. And from here, you can either have your heels pretty close to your hips, or you're gonna send them forward, and they might become parallel to the front edge of your mat. Sit up nice and tall. You can stay seated. This is a big hip opener. Or start to crawl it forward. And you're in Gomukhasana. I really like flipping my palms up, being on my forearms, so I'm ready to receive here. If you want to use that little shake of the tailbone, just wag the tailbone back and forth. You'll start to feel the movement shimmy up the spine. You may even start to feel your head start to shake, but it's gonna start to release tension. And if you're anything like me, my house is a freaking madhouse. I need anything I can get to release tension, and what the heck schools out until the end of the year. My gosh, are you kidding me? Yeah. Today was not the day to announce that, Governor. No. Governor.
My kids were
awful. Sorry, Berkeley, if you're watching. Okay, walk the hands back. Parallel the shin. So fire log, Abhisthanabhasana. So we're gonna do our best to stack the shins. If this is like, it doesn't matter if the shin is lifted at all, but if this is like excruciating for your knees for any reason, just take the pose we started in, Sukhasana, crossing at the shins. Just remember which shin you have in front. Should be right. So you're gonna sit up tall. Again, doesn't matter if this knee is lifted. Sit up tall and start to walk yourself forward and fold. Again, great place to use the little tailbone shake. Keep the feet super flexed here. Don't let them kind of just hang out. Keep them active, flexed. You can take a block underneath the sit bones, thank you, Wendy. Or you can even put a block under the forehead. Start to walk the hands back to the shins. Wish we had more time. Okay, come back into that Ardha Matsyendrasana. So just bring the right foot to the mat. And you're gonna crawl to your left. Lifting the hips. And sit yourself down. Ah, yeah, okay. So now your left shin is in front. Foot down on the mat. Right heel outside of left hip. Left hand supports, right arm lifts. Hook the elbow and twist. So really use that support. If you found the bind on the other side, attempt to find it on this side. The hooking of the fingers allows me to lift a little more. And the belly in and up, crown of the head tall. Good, turn forward. Go Mukhasana, we're gonna stack our knees, left on top. Either keep the heels close to the hips, it'll be less intense, or start to walk them forward, maybe parallel, make one straight line. Sit up super tall, and then crawl it forward. Find that slight little shake, turn the palms up. Walk the hands back. Abhisthanabhasana. So stacking. If you guys have been in a class with me and we do this pose, I walk around, everybody's like, you really want your foot, the top foot, to hang off so you can flex it. Because if it's here, it's hard to manipulate it, you know, if it's sitting on the knee. So let it hang off. Let this knee go as high as it needs to go. Flex the right foot, sit tall. And then start to drop it down, maybe palms face up here, shake through the tailbone. Good, So finishing class with a hip opener is probably my favorite, especially a night practice, because it's gonna get you nice and rested, ready for sleep. So keep breathing here. Keeping both feet active and flexed. Hi, Anthony.
He waved at us.
Start to crawl it up. Unwind. Oh, shake it out. Those are intense hip openers. Bend the knees, soles of the feet down, drop the tailbone, roll all the way down. Come into Savasana. So here is your architecture for your pose right here. For this finishing pose, the most healing. Dare I say the most beneficial pose in yoga. Start to slow the breath. Just let everything melt into the earth. Notice you're supported. Actually, gonna leave you guys in your Savasana to take it as long as you like or short. But bringing your hands to the heart if you're finishing up here, closing the eyes, just wanted to say a couple final words. This idea, this really empowering idea that you are your own architect, the architect of your life in every area. And that you have the ability to call in and manifest, create what you want in your life. Whoa, it's big, if you really think about it. The light and love within me honors, salutes, and recognizes the light and love within each one of you. Always remember you are enough, and don't let anyone steal your peace. Namaste, yogis.
Namaste, Archer. Namaste, Archer.